We will be speaking on pre-operative checklist to proceed to a case of routine cataract surgery. I introduce with me is Dr. Twinkle Shah from Ahmedabad, and I am Dr. Purendra Basin, and I welcome you all for this very good breakfast session, morning session.
Good morning to everybody. I thank the organizers and Surendar for including me in the list of the speakers. I'll share my experience with you regarding this pre-operative checklist. Generally, if you read the title, you feel that it is very less important subject, but it is in the era of NABH, it is very important. So I have no financial interest. The importance of the checklist is it improves the quality, outcome, and the safety of your patients. It avoids the complications and legal issues. If you have a standard checklist, it works even in our absence. Like when we attend the conferences, the team will run. See, the facts about the comorbidities are there where it requires a pre-operative attention. In my experience of 40 years, personally, I have done 92,000 cataracts, both in the government sector and private sector. I learned many things from my mistakes. So in the era of 1980s, when I entered the service, it is the era of ICAMS and ICCA, where those days also we used to maintain the checklist, but it is very simple, which can be practiced in the remote places. Now in the era, NABH era, I can say it is NABH era. So we are having a high-end setup called Medivision. I am the medical director, where we perform 10,000 surgeries per annum. So the checklist in our institute is the patient counselor, nurse, and the resident doctor, anesthetist, and surgeon all together maintain different checklists, not one. This is the checklist of the counselor, where that fellow is having 23 items to check before admission. His main duty is confirmation of the patient, estimation letter, approval letter regarding the finance, then the confirmation of the IOL box, correct power, and the generation of a wristband with a barcode. Then the patient is admitted in the ward, where the nurse is having 16 items of the checklist, where her duty is identification of the patient, identification of the site, and the marking of the eye. If it is a right eye, red mark, left eye, green mark. So the vitals are checked, preoperative medication is given, pupillary dilatation is done, time of the last food is taken, is noted by the nurse. Then the patient went to the resident doctor, where that fellow is having 16 items to confirm. So where the doctor's assessment, applicable consent form, preoperative checklist. Then pre-anesthetic checkup, anesthesia consent form, surgical checklist, and the investigations. Then to simplify for you, the Vision 2020 has given some guidelines. They have given 16 items before the go out for the cataract surgery. So that I will come one by one. So the identification of the patient is by the generation of the wristband, which consisting of the patient name, the type of the procedure, package, eye, and the barcode. In our institute, we identify simply by name and his mobile number. Then drug allergies are noted when the patient first visits to our hospital. There is a box called allergy box. So where we maintain, these are the allergy to the patients. So in our institute, instead of xylocaine, we use xylocard to avoid the unnecessary xylocaine sensitivity and the drug reactions. So for the vision, PL and PR is necessary when the vision is less than 3 meters and you are not able to evaluate the fundus. So local examination concentrate on the cornea, pupil, lens, and the fundus, where it is necessary for the cataract surgery. So intraocular pressure is measured 1 day prior to the surgery at least, and the proper treatment is given. The syringing is done one day prior to the surgery. So all the cases, the other eye biometry is a must to avoid the errors and possibility of the amblyopia. In the case of total cataract, B-scan is a must to avoid the post-operative problems. The consent is taken not only for the surgery, but also for anesthesia, alternate procedures, and the permission for postponement. In the blood pressure should be normal. Avoid the adrenaline in blood pressure patients. If still there is a high pressure, use IV midazolam just before surgery. Blood sugar should be normal. We allow normal diet and normal medication. So in the congenital swab is not necessary for all patients, but special cases it requires. The surgical plan should be noted where it is a site of incision, type of the IOL. So the preoperative antibiotic prophylaxis is the moxifloxacin 4 times a day, 1 day prior to the surgery, betadine paint in the ward, betadine drops in the anteroom. Dilatation is half an hour before surgery, but we avoid dilatation in some of the patients who are prone for angle closure glaucoma. See, the cardiac patients don't take before 3 months after the attack and take the certificate from cardiologist, always operate them under in the presence of anesthetist. Asthmatics requires oxygen inhalation and avoid NSAIDs. Before anesthesia, our anesthetist, who is with me for the last 25 years, identify the patient, procedure, site, consent, pre-surgical assessment, pre-anesthetic assessment. Then I'll do the job of identity of the patient, site and the procedure, type of implant, power of the implant, etc. Then after the completion of the surgery, the theater nurse verifies whether I have done good job or bad job, and the lens label is attached. This girl also with me for the last 25 years. Take home message is, the checklist is a must for a cataract surgeon. It prevents adverse effects. It increases the value and volume of your hospital. Customize your own list according to the facilities available and volume of your hospital. And follow the international standards at the same time. Once again, I thank you for giving the opportunity.